Hello friends, thanks for clicking and welcome to my channel only for civil engineers. In this video we will discuss about most important multiple choice questions in bridge engineering. This video is helpful for BMC or MCGM Sub Engineer Exam, and it is also helpful for various competitive exams related to civil engineering. So let's start. First question of this video is, generally a culvert has span less than 6 meter. Second question is, a bridge of span 25 meter may be treated as minor bridge. Third question is, a bridge of more than dash meter span is treated as long span bridge. So a bridge of more than 120 meter span is treated as long span bridge. Fourth question is, as far as possible, the alignment of a bridge should be square. Fifth question is, temporary bridges are built during. So these temporary bridges are built during military operations, during project executions, and also for rescue operations. So for this question, option D, all of the above, is the correct answer. Next question is, movable bridges are built across channels. Next question is, a bascule bridge is a movable bridge. Next one is, which one of the following is not a low cost bridge? So among these four bridges, masonry bridge is not a low cost bridge, and remaining these three, that is wooden bridge, floating bridge and movable bridge, are low cost bridge. Next question is, the end supports of a bridge superstructure are known as abutments. Next one is, the floor provided between masonry walls below the river bed is known as curtain wall. Next question is, width and height of curves on bridges are generally dash mm respectively. So the width and height of curves on bridges are generally 600 mm and 225 mm respectively. Next question is, the roadside slope of curb is 1 in 8. Next one is, in case of alluvial streams, linear waterway is determined by Lucy's formula as L is equal to C into Q raised to 1/2, where Q is discharge and C is dash, depending upon the local conditions. So here value of C is 4.5 to 6.3. Next question is, which one of the following is not the correct statement? So first statement is, bridge side should be narrow. It is correct statement. Bridge side should not possess high banks. This is incorrect statement. Third statement is, bridge site should be at reasonable proximity to the direct alignment of road. This is correct statement. And fourth statement is, bridge site should be geologically sound. It is also correct statement. So for this question, option B is correct answer. Next question is, preliminary survey should be carried out at least dash meter distance on upstream and downstream side. So preliminary survey should be carried out to at least 200 to 500 meter distance on upstream and downstream side. Next one is, in preliminary survey, cross sections at dash meter interval should be determined. So in preliminary survey, cross sections at 50 meter interval should be determined. Next one is, height of bridge is kept dash meter above high flood level. So height of bridge is kept 1.2 to 1.5 meter above flood high flood level. Next one is, masonry arch bridges are used to span 3 to 15 meter. Next question is, slab bridges are used to a maximum span of 9 meter. Next question is, the cross section of a pier may be. So the cross section of pier may be rectangular, it is correct. It may be with the triangular edges up towards upstream and downstream sides. It is also correct. And it is with curved faces on upstream and downstream sides. This is also correct. So for this question, option D, all of the above is the correct answer. Next question is, the height of concrete pier may be raised by dash mm every day during the construction. So the height of concrete pier may be raised by 600 mm in every day during the construction. Next one is, RCC piers of the following shapes are not used. So among these four options, T-shape is not used in RCC piers. Next one is, in the design of piers, the water pressure to be considered is. So in the design of piers, the water pressure is to be considered static pressure, it may be dynamic pressure, and also impact due to cross current. So for this question, option D, all of the above is the correct answer. Next question is, the most suitable foundation for a culvert is spread foundation. Next one is, for a major bridge, usually the type of foundation is well foundation. Next question is, bridge over a dry valley is known as viaduct. Next one is, the bridge having its floor flush with bed of stream is known as causeway. Next question is, which one of the following is not a type of culvert? So among these four options, through culvert is not a type of culvert, and remain three, that is pipe culvert, box culvert, and slab culvert are the types of culvert. Next question is, minimum depth of foundation below the score line in a arch bridge for piers should not be less than 1.8 meter. Next question is, the arrangement made to prevent entry of water at the site of pier construction is known as cofferdam. Next one is, Fixed plate bearing plates are suitable for spans up to 12 meter. Next question is, deep cast bearings are suitable up to dash meter span. So these deep cast bearings are suitable up to 12 to 20 meter spans. Next question is, rocker bearings are suitable for spans up to more than 20 meter. Next one is, if a rocker and roller bearing is provided at one end of a bridge girder, then the other end will be rocker bearing. Next question is, match list 1 with list 2 by selecting the options given in question. So here list 1 gives types of bridge and list 2 gives span. So here girder bridge has 10 to 60 meter span, cable stair bridge has 300 to 600 meter span, truss bridge has 30 to 378 meter span, and suspension bridge has over 500 meter span. So for this question, option D is correct answer. Next question is, causeway has flush with bed of stream, culvert has span less than 6 meter, viaduct is a bridge over a dry valley, and bascule bridge is a movable bridge. So for this question, Option C is correct answer. Next question is, select your answer according to the coding system given for assertion A and reason R. So assertion is given that if linear waterway is reduced, depth of foundation is to be increased. This is the correct assertion. Now reason is, there is increase in core depth if linear waterway is reduced, and this is the correct reason of this statement. So for this question, option A, both A and R are true, and R is the correct explanation of option of statement A. Next question is, assertion is given that straight abutments are not suitable for waterways. This is correct assertion. Now reason of that assertion is, water penetrates behind abutments and damages embankments. This is the correct reason, correct statement, and this is also correct reason of this statement. So here option A, both A and R are true, and R is the correct explanation of statement A is the correct. Next question is, assertion is given that usually skin of pier is with rich concrete and hard with poor concrete. It is correct statement, and reason of it, it is economize the construction cost. It is a correct statement, and it is correct explanation of statement A. So here option A is correct answer. Both A and R are true, and R is the correct explanation of statement A. Now last question is, state whether the following statement is true or false. So statement is, if bridge is at bottom level of superstructure, it is known as through bridge. So if bridge is at bottom level of superstructure, then it is known as through bridge. So it is true statement. So here option A is correct answer. So here this video is finished. I hope this video will be helpful for you. For more updates, subscribe my channel, and don't forget to share this video with your friends.